one entry in our red four-year-old class, but really a beautiful cow here. Cow been milking since September yet and still has that tremendous dairy frame and then that beautiful mammary system to go along with it. Real snug attachments, veins all over her udder, and a lot of bloom to her mammary yet. Certainly a cow you'd like to see with some more competition.
And now we're ready to start showing the four-year-olds in the black and white show, the class number 17. The trophy for this class is sponsored by the Intermountain Farms Association and Agri-Service. Four-year-old cows to the arena, please.
Thank you.
this time I'm going to ask Joey to make another introduction of a guest. As I said, this year, especially in many years past, we try to introduce the people that have been
there's a trip in the ceiling, right? There you go.
Anyway, there's a gentleman that Joey's going to introduce to you that I'm sure all of you have had something to do with him, or many of you have, through your industry. How many of you have ever used a bull that had to go 100 H? Anyway, there's the guy right there. For many years, Larry Gerber and Jack Burton had operated GLG. And anyway, this is his first year in Richmond. Joey, please introduce that distinguished gentleman.
Thank you. I'm here with Larry Gerber from Oakdale, California. And believe it or not, he is a first-time visitor to the Western Spring National. Larry, what brings you here today?
Well, first of all, I want to say it's really a pleasure to be here in Utah. This is my first trip, and what a beautiful venue. I'm here with Legendary Farms. This is our first time to the Western National in quite a few years. And just a great show, and the hospitality has been fantastic.
Larry, you've been real involved with California Holstein Association. What's new and exciting with the California group?
Well, we just had our California State Holstein show, and there's a few animals that have come out to Utah this year. We had a great show. Our judge was Mike Heath. Last year, we had Justin Burdett judge our State Holstein show. And everybody out there, we just had the Ocean View Dispersal and the Earthquake Sale, and we've been real active out there. A great average at the Ocean View Dispersal, I believe it was right around $2,700. And people have asked me if I'm still with JLG. No, I retired about a year ago, and now I'm kind of semi-retired, and I'm working with Ron Piersma at Legendary.
Wow, what are some of the goals that Ron has with his operation at Legendary?
Well, Ron is no stranger to the dairy industry. He has a great herd of cows down there. Ron has added some great herds to his herd down there, the great Skagville herd, Sleepy Hollow, Ocean View, and just quite a few, Canyon Breeze, a lot of great animals from the Abigail family. And our goal basically is maybe to promote our registered Holsteins and kind of climb the ladder a little bit.
Pleasure visiting with you, Larry. Let's welcome him to the Western Spring National. Thank you very much, Larry.
Yeah, Larry, we hope that this definitely isn't your first and last trip. We enjoy having you here, and definitely glad to hear that you're working with Ron Peterson at Legendary Farms, and good luck to you. And we really appreciate having you here today, and great contribution to the AI industry. There was a lot of polls, of course, that you're didn't pass the health test that couldn't get to Ohio or Wisconsin, and Larry housed a lot of those bulls in California. For example, our bull that our judge bred, Whitney Knowles Pronto, that bull has been at JLT for many years, and excellent operation out there that he and Jack did for 30-some years, and now Larry, of course, is a Legendary Holstein. So anyway, welcome to the show today. I mentioned also that we tried to get Ron to come up, but Ron's kind of a humble guy, and he's using Larry as a spokesman. But anyway, it was certainly a pleasure having him today. Now I'd like to direct your attention to the center of the arena right now, and Justin is going to make a presentation right now for the Al Hay Award. And if you'd like to know a little bit more about the Al Hay Award, Justin's probably going to tell you a little bit about it. Al Hay was a master showman from Carnation Milk Farms in Carnation, Washington for many years. And this is an award that they awarded a special exhibitor that has a lot of sportsmanship and definitely displays in a professional all the way through, and somebody that's admired by all, and somebody that definitely is a true. It's kind of like the MVP of the NFL. Anyway, it's the MVP of the Dairy Showman. Okay, I'm going to turn to Justin. Go ahead.
Thank you, Jim. This year's winner of the Al Hay Award possesses all of the qualities Al Hay was known for as a fitter. He spends countless days traveling as a fitter, is friendly and helpful to all exhibitors alike. This individual is constantly putting an animal's needs first. He makes all aspects of getting cattle ready, from feeding, washing, and clipping, to showing top priority, portraying the true qualities of a top-notch fitter and true cowman. All attributes, high standards, and qualities that Al Hay portrayed. This individual has been a fitter for over 15 years. and continues to be recognized as one of the top fitters and cowmen in the industry today. He has not only gotten ready countless All-American and All-Canadian winners, along with numerous grand champions in his career, including Shoremar Alicia, Penlow Georgette Outside, and Fletdell R. Marker Mamie. His love for the industry and passion for great cows has allowed him to not only sell many All-Canadian winners, but in 2011, he owned part of three individuals who were nominated as summer yearlings in Canada, including the winning summer yearling, Hardy Goldwyn Shimmer. Another individual who has become a crowd favorite as she has matured, XL's Dundee Beauty, is owned with Triple T Holsteins, Sharp, Bennett, and Van Exel. She was the unanimous All-American Age Cow and Reserve All-Canadian Mature Cow in 2011. Not limited to his North American borders, this individual also co-owns the Swiss Expo Champion from 2012, De Crozat Iron Ocolibra, with GS Alliance in Switzerland. While his purchases and sales have not been limited to North America, neither has his fitting career. Always a love of great Western shows, this individual has fit for herds across the Western states and Canada for most of his career. Most recently, helping West Coast Holsteins in British Columbia. He's also traveled all over the world to many countries, including Colombia, Mexico, Italy, Brazil, and Australia. This dedicated cowman is married with two children and lives in Angola, Indiana, where he buys, develops, and sells high-type animals, accenting his fitting career. His incredible sense of humor and great knowledge of pedigrees and the industry makes him truly unique. Please welcome this year's Al Hay Award winner, Pat Conroy, or better known to most of us as Cowboy.
Congratulations, Cowboy. We're proud of you.
It's your turn, Cowboy.
Congratulations. We'll go over in front and get a picture in front of the sign.
Thanks. Congratulations, Pat. You've been coming to Richmond for as long as I can remember.
Doctor them all up like you do now.
Thanks so much, Jerry. We appreciate it. Here in that, as time goes on, there are some of these pioneers that we certainly know that we owe a lot to. And Al Hay was definitely one of those individuals. Thank you for your contribution to what kind of a man he truly was, Jerry. Thank you. Bickford has completed the showing for the class 17, the 4-year-olds. I'd like to have the juniors take a couple steps forward, please. And our first place junior.
It's 112.
Our first place junior is. Our first place junior has got to be number 118, Mr. Cade Harris, Rainy Ridge Regiment Jackie. And now for the winners in the class, our third place is also our junior winner in the class in the open show. Our second place animal and second place best udder is Dardell Dundee Tierra from TNL Cattle. And our first place in the class and the first place best udder goes to Powell Brothers Damian Campbell from Pat Conroy and Bud John Farms. Congratulations, and here is Judge Burnett. Your comments, please.
Well, another really nice group here, and right to the bottom, just a great lineup of cows, and right at the top here, these first three, four cows come to the top for me. But the cow I'm going to start with today, just a beautifully balanced cow, a cow that's got quality from end to end. She's a cow that, for me, excels in dairy strength. She's got width, a muzzle width through the chest floor, spring to her fore and her rear rib, and a cow that, when she gets out on the move, tracks out so nicely on her hind legs, and then just wears that mammary system so snugly attached. I like the strength to the forerudder attachment. Just a little more snap right at the top of the rearudder for me today, a little more quality to the halvings of the rearudder today. Over the beautiful frame cow here in second. Cow in second, the cow you certainly admire, that frame, the high chine, the width through the hooks and pins. Another cow that moves out quite nicely on her hind legs. Just a little freer moving cow for me here in second. And a cow that's just a little more level on the floor of her udder, just a little snugger about her attachments, and the beautiful red cow coming in third.
Sorry.
Cow in third's a cow that, again, has that same kind of frame, the nice uphill run, the big drop and sweep to her fore and rear rib. And a cow that's just got a little more quality for me today the whole way through. Remember a recently fresh cow coming out here in fourth. Cow in fourth, just a few weeks fresh. You love that big frame that she has, the uphill run. Just needs to get chiseled down a little more today. Just cleaned off some back through the thigh, a little more quality to her runner to move up higher. But she uses that advantage, just a little more capacity, a little more snugness to her attachments than her real dairy frame cow here in fifth. Cow in fifth, just a little more pleasing for me from the side view, a little longer from end to end, a little more extension to her quarter, just a little more smoother blending the whole way through than a nice rear cow we have following in sixth. Really a beautiful dairy frame cow here to win our five-year-old class. A cow that you love that angularity from end to end. And then the cow, when you get to the beautiful mammary system, you love the quality of the attachments, the beautiful venation to the side view of the udder, and a cow that you really admire the capacity she has the whole way through.
Thank you, Justin. Class number 18, five-year-old cows in the Black and White Show are now coming into the arena. The trophy for this class is sponsored by Cache County Farm Bureau and LD's Cafe.
Thank you. right now at this time. I'm going to introduce Dan Murray. He has an award that he wants to make. This is
called the Associate Al Hay Award. It's kind of like for the industry person. And Dan?
The Al Hay Award last year, was an associate member of the Al Hay Group. I was the first nominated last year, and I'm proud to announce the associate member for this year. He's a well-respected member of the industry here in this area, a good friend to all of us, respected by us all, and very involved and has been for a long, long time. I'd like to introduce Mr. Jerry Stranglin. Jerry came out here in the Northwest in 1967 as a field man up here in the Northwest. We all got acquainted with it. My first met him back in the middle 70s when I was working there. I lived in the game by and was working for All West and just started then. He was out there in the picture. He's in the office for All West. And I've known him ever since. And I'm very well respected by myself and all of us. He's a great friend. He worked for All West for a number of years and then went into the department business on his own. And there probably aren't very many people at all the ringside of the game that Jerry hasn't taken pictures for. And certain Northwest Holstein Limited publication that has circulation all over the West, advertisements and so on. And I don't remember what year it was, but many, many years. Started putting out, publishing the Washington Holstein Annual, and now there's the Northwest Holstein Annual, which includes the whole Northwest region up here. Jerry is the person that, you know, we talked a little bit about history, the lead up here near the Long area this morning. He's just wealth of knowledge. He's been a real supporter of this Al Hay Award, you know, since its inception. Anyway, I'm proud to present Mr. Jerry Stranglin. If you can hold him, please. Jerry, talk a little more. Maybe we can invite him to talk to us a little bit more. He has a really good history. He just rolled out a little bit of the LA Award. Anyway, congratulations, Jerry.
Seems like a dream. And at this time, I'd like to announce the winners in the 5-year-old cows, class number 18. We do not have any juniors in this class.
The first place bred known in the class will go to entry number 129, Legendary Shanny from Legendary Farms in Chino, California. The third place animal is entry number 130, Robin Hood Clumbo, owned by Dave Brown. The second place and second place bestseller is number 124, Lake Furry and Ava Red from West Coast All States. And the winner in the class, the number place bestseller, is Greenway Global Warming from West Coast All States. Congratulations.
Well, just a super group of cows here in our 5-year-old class right down to the bottom of the class. And what a beautiful cow we have to start out with here. A cow that's got that tremendous frame to her. She's got size and scale. She's got the uphill run. She's got that dairy hide, the quality the whole way through. And she's a cow that just wears a beautiful mammary system today. She's snug in her attachments. She's level on the floor of her udder. She's got a little more definition of that rear seam. Just a little tighter right to the top of the rear udder. And then an ultra dairy frame cow coming here in second. Cow in second, a cow you love that quality that she possesses from end to end. She's got that silky hide, that nice openness the whole way through. Just a little cleaner for me up through the head, neck, over the shoulder, back through the hooks and pins, and a recently fresh cow here in third. Cow in third, just fresh about a month. You certainly admire her on her third calf here. She wears that udder so high above the hock. You love the beautiful attachments. A little snugger in her forerunner, a little more extension to the floor of her forerunner, and just a little more snap right to the top of her rear udder than the beautiful frame cow here in fourth. Cow in fourth is just a cow that excels in that dairy strength and quality the whole way through. A cow that when you pick her apart, she doesn't have a lot of holes in her. You just maybe like to snug her up in her udder attachments today, see a little more milk in her to get her up higher. But she uses that advantage just to blend it a little smoother the whole way through, just a little higher the way she carries her udder above her hocks, and our fifth place cow coming out here. Cow in fifth, another cow that excels in that dairy strength. She's got that big open frame. She's a cow that's got a little more size and scale, just a little more level from hooks to pins, and a little more bloom to her udder today than our real silky eyed cow here in sixth.
Thank you. Cow in the 6 years and older in the red division. Entry is 138, Stouter SSI, Lady Red. This animal is owned by Kent Craig Butters. This animal was bred by Shana Marie Stouter Links. Your comments, please. Dismember it.
Only one entry in the age cow class here, but really a beautiful cow. Cow's got a big square frame, a cow that wears her udder well above her hocks, and really shows she's wore the test of time quite well, and certainly a cow you really admire, just that tremendous strength she possesses the whole way through.
Thank you.
Oh, okay. Let me see. This award was for... Yes.
At this time, I'm going to ask Mr. Kyle Olson to make a presentation award. This is for the Distinguished Service Award. He has some individuals that he's going to present this to. And Al, I'm going to turn the mic over to you.
Thank you, Jim. It's an honor and privilege to present the Service Award to the Utah Olson Association. I'd ask Alan and Dolores Peter, if you'd please come up there.
Yeah, there. Listen better. I'd like to tell you a little bit about this terrific family. In 1966, a family owned and operated farms took a chance on a small Swiss cheese maker, Edwin Gosner. With those families' help and support, Gosner Foods Incorporated was born in the little Switzerland of the Rockies, Cache Valley. Today, Gosner's is one of the largest Swiss cheese manufacturers in the world, but they have not forgotten that without the support of the community, the dairy farmer families, and loyal employees, Gosner's would not be around today. Gosner's was founded on the idea of people working together and helping each other. Those ideas are not lost with Dolores Wheeler. With that in mind, Gosner's has made an effort to give back to those same people who have helped get Gosner's to where they are today. Alan and Dolores live on a farm in Lewiston, Utah, where Dolores spent many hours out on the tractor or on a horse moving cows from pasture to pasture. When Gosner's first started, the only milk they had was from the Alan and Dolores dairy. Dolores Wheeler is the CEO, president of Gosner Foods, and the daughter of Edwin Gosner Sr. Alan and Dolores have two daughters, Patricia and Wayne Gibbs, and Dixie and Alan Beauty. They have seven grandchildren, seven great-grandchildren. Gosner's is a fourth-generation family-owned company, and many family members are still actively working for the company. Much like her father, Dolores gives all the credit of her success to the support from the local community. Gosner Foods receives milk from 150-plus farm families in the Cache Valley. That is a lot of people depending on Gosner's, and a lot of people Gosner's depend on. Alan and Dolores and Gosner's have sponsored USU athletics for over 15 years. As many of you are aware, the Gosner Classic that they have at the basketball tournament. And it's a great tradition every year. Each month, the donation of cheese, milk, and butter is made to Utah food banks. Gosner's is a sponsor to the Cache Valley Dairy Ambassadors and the Princesses. Gosner's helps to sponsor local scouting events, farmer markets, churches, high schools, and our troops. They spend a lot of time and effort there in supporting our troops and other community events. Many schools bring classes to Gosner's to teach the children about the importance of agriculture and the process of creating the dairy products that they eat each and every day. It is indeed a pleasure and honor, because I am one of those 150 family farms that sell my milk to Gosner's, and they are so supportive and treat us just like family. And Utah Holstein Association would like to present the Distinguished Service Award to Alan and Dolores Wheeler. They continually help with the Richmond Show each year. They sponsor classes. They help with the judging contests and in any way that they can to support us. And we appreciate that very much. Congratulations to Alan and Dolores Wheeler.
Congratulations to you. You're truly an advocate of this
And at this time, I'm going to ask Jody to also introduce another guest. As I said earlier, we've tried to introduce a lot of the guests. It's our first time here. It's been certainly a lot of this individual that she's going to introduce here, but he is a person that is quite instrumental and presently utilizing him as one of our officers, board members for the Holstein Association, and our current national vice president. I'm not going to say anymore. Jody, introduce him.
Thank you. I have with me Glenn Brown. As Jim just said, he is our Holstein Association USA Vice President. We're very proud to have him as part of our organization, and you should too as a leader in representing you as dairy producers. A lot of what the Holstein Association does revolves around member input, and a lot of that comes through committees. Glenn, I know TIPE Committee is meeting next week. Why don't you tell us a little bit about what they're up to?
Next week, our TIPE committee will be meeting in Milwaukee, and they will be reviewing the TIPE data that we're accumulating and looking at proposed changes or ways to improve and possible emphasis changes in terms of how we do our TIPE evaluation. We have some very important and very knowledgeable people who sit on this TIPE committee, and they'll be spending some time next week reviewing where we're going in the future in regards to our TIPE.
Now, also relating to TIPE, we're very excited that we have enlisted the help of a well-known artist named Bonnie Moore in a little project. Glenn, why don't you tell us about that?
We're excited to be able to introduce a new True TIPE cow model that will be introduced or presented at the National Convention in Springfield, Missouri next month. That's been being worked on for quite some time, and there's a lot of excitement associated with that. As you know, over the years we've updated our True TIPE model. Many of you probably have more than one of them on your shelves at home, and in the near future you'll be able to add the latest version of that after that's revealed at our convention here next month, Jeremy.
There's a blog, even, I understand, on our website that you can follow as Bonnie's working on these paintings. There's a new cow and a new bull. From what I've seen of the bull, he's going to be a pretty looking, good-looking guy. Glenn, also, you mentioned National Convention coming up in just about a month. What do we have planned in store that's exciting for folks to know about our National Convention plans?
As you know, annually we hold our national convention in different parts of the country, and this year our national convention will be in Springfield, Missouri, and we're going to be honored to have John Anderson from our area here. John's walking around the group here today, and he's going to be a guest speaker at the national convention speaking on the issue of genomics. As you know, John is very knowledgeable in this area and has already participated in some of our winter forums and has done such a fine job. He's going to be one of our keynote speakers at the National Convention. We invite all of you to take a family vacation and make that part of what you're going to do as a family this summer and join the Holstein Association in Springfield next month.
Now, I know the board has also spent quite a bit of time lately talking about genetic evaluations. Glenn, if you would just briefly maybe let folks know what some of the discussion is there.
As you know, USDA is considering taking the TIPE evaluation function out of the responsibility of USDA, moving it over to the Council on Dairy Cattle Breeding. This is a very significant consideration that is being made right now. I would hope that all of you who are involved in the dairy industry, especially those of you who milk cows each day, get yourselves as informed as you can on this issue. As you know, we have the gold standard throughout the world as it relates to our sire evaluation, and we've led the world for many decades. And this is a significant consideration. And Holstein has some concerns about this, and I trust that all of you do as you. But above all, I want you to be informed. You need to study this issue and look at what's being considered. The association is putting on their website some things that we would like you to review and look at, and whether you communicate with those of us at Holstein or with your national DHI or your local DHI association or even your AI units that serve you, that you need to get informed on this issue and make your concerns, your understanding of this known to those who will have the responsibility of ultimately deciding if this should happen and when and how. But we are pleading with you to get informed on this issue, and as an association, we're doing our best to represent what we feel is the interest of the average dairy farmer in this country.
So more information can be found at our website, www.holsteinusa.com. Pleasure visiting with you, Glenn, Holstein USA Vice President. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Jody. And I want to express my appreciation to Jody and all those from our staff, our classifier, and all those who are involved. We appreciate all they do to improve the protocol here at Richmond. Thank you very much for your efforts in being here.
Thank you very much, Glenn. Have a good national convention. Thank you, Jody. Our judge has now completed the judging for the 6-year-old cows. We don't have any juniors in this class. I would like to announce the winners. And in third place is Happy's Roy King, the World War II from Alexei Happy, Georgia, of New York. In second place, the number 134, second place, best letter. Favorite Golden Matilda from TNL Cattle. And our winner in the class, in first place, Red Zone, first place, best letter, is Lona Lindgren Davis, Bill Thorpe of New York. Congratulations.
Well, just 6 real super age cows here. Not a bad cow in this class, and it's a shame one's got to be 6, but they're really just a nice uniform group of cows here. And what a beautifully balanced cow here to start the class. A cow that, again, excels in that dairy strength. Yes, she's got quality from end to end. She's got the big uphill run, the high arch to her back, the tremendous open rib. And then you get to that great mammary system, just quality to her udder the whole way through, a lot of height and width right to the top of the rear udder. And she uses that advantage in her overall, just fuller the whole way through than the real streamlined cow we have coming out here in a second. Cow in second, you really admire the youthfulness that she has. A cow just wears her udder a little higher above her hocks for me today. Her teats hang a little more plumb underneath the udder, a little nicer the way they sit on the forequarters, and just a little fuller right at the top of the rear udder than her beautiful open frame cow coming out here in third. Cow in third's another real quality cow from end to end. She's just got a little more style and balance for me today, just a little more quality from end to end, just a little nicer through that rear rib down through the rear flank, and the way the forearm blends into the body wall than a real upstanding cow coming out here in fourth. Cow in fourth, a cow that's had 5 calves, still wears her udder well above the hock. You really love that big uphill run that she has, the openness and width that she has the whole way through. And she just uses that advantage of being a little more cow the whole way through over a pair of real well-balanced cows coming out here in fifth and sixth today.
Thank you much, Justin. And if you like marker head logs, 133 is first. And our judge has lined up the 125,000 pound class. If you have one here, take a step forward. David, this is man with the number one person tonight. He will be third place in the class. Our first place here, Cash Valley, the Light Durham. And now for a second place in the class, and second place, best starter, Happy Stanley Bessie from Happy's Farms of Ogden, Utah. And first place in the class is entry number 143, Legendary Rhonda. First place, Brendo. First place, Best Cutter from Legendary Farms of Chino, California. Congratulations. And your comments, please.
Well, four real outstanding cows here in our production class. Cows have really stood the test of time, and they've wore extremely well. All four of these cows carried their udders right up above their hocks. They've had four to five calves. They produced a lot of milk. And I think we've got a real nice pair of cows here at the top of the class. And the cow we're going to start with here today, for me, just a little more complete cow the whole way through. She's got the uphill run, just a little more width down through the floor of her chest, a little more heart for me, a little fuller through her midsection, and then just a touch bit snugger to her forewater than the ultra dairy cow we have coming in second. Cow in second, you really admire that dairy quality she has from end to end, a cow that's got a tremendous mammary system. You love the capacity to the rear udder attachment there, and a cow that just moves out a little freer on her hind legs, a little smoother as she goes around the ring, and the real big frame cow coming here in third. Cow in third's another cow, you love the uphill run, the big sweep to her rib, and for me, just a little fuller, a little more master her midsection today, a little more quality to her mammary system than a recently fresh cow coming out here in fourth.
Thank you, guys. And if you'd like to mark your dad off, then you're number 149 third, you're number 140 second, you're number 141 scratch, you're number 142 fourth, and if you're number 143 with the winner, Legendary Rhonda, Legendary Farms for Chino, California. Next class that we will be showing for the senior champion in the red show.
Too much recommendation, so we can't decide. I didn't have 4 more years of your resignation.
I'd like to make some introductions here on some of the channels that have a woman today. If any winners are registered today, the 4-year-old panel is one of my entry 2018 rating series, Reggie Jackie.
Our selection for senior champion here in our red show today. Only the 3 cows brought back out here, but certainly a beautiful group of cows here. Our 4-year-old, our 5-year-old, and our age cow. Real nice udder cows. They got a lot of quality from end to end of their cows. They got tremendous feet and legs. And for me, when they get pulled back out here, there's a real nice pair of cows. And that's going to be our 5-year-old, will be our senior champion cow, following her with our 4-year-old for reserve. Just giving the 5-year-old a little advantage, just a little more dairy quality for me the whole way through, a little cleaner hide it, and just a little more balance to the floor of rudder than the real nice deep rib 4-year-old cow that'll be a reserve grand champ or senior champion, and then follow her with her age for honorable mention. Congratulations.
Congratulations to the Red Show senior champion. Yeah, give them a big round of applause.
Yeah. And then
in our selection here for a grand champion of a red and white show. We didn't have the largest red and white show, but really four nice cows brought back out here for our grand champion lineup with our two intermediate champions and our two senior champions. But for me today, we're going to go ahead and stay with our senior champions for grand and reserve. Just give them a little bit of the doubt on that maturity today, and they're really nice quality pair of cows here that fit together quite well for me. Congratulations. In our selection for senior champion of our junior show here, only three cows brought back out, but a real nice group of cows here. And for me today, it's quite handy. The young man with that red four-year-old cow will be your senior champion cow. And then we're going to follow with our 125,000-pound cow for your reserve senior champion. Really a nice pair of dairy cows with a real great rear runners here and just put together a nice pair of cows.
Senior champion in the junior division. provincial junior division.
Will they do a junior grand for both?
Yes. This is for the next class that we're in. Anyway, so now you can see. Just
cows in the arena.
In our selection for our Junior Show Grand Champion here, before we go too far, give all our junior exhibitors a nice round of applause for the heifers and cows they've had here. We've got four real nice cows brought back out here for our grand champion selection. And for me, it's quite handy, the young man with his red four-year-old there. She'll be your grand champion of the junior show today. And a little closer for reserve, but the young man with that two-year-old cow, pull her around here. A cow is certainly a bright future here. You really love that frame that she has. Still holding her milk right in there nicely. And just give her a little advance. Just put together a little nicer for me today than our 100,000-pound cow that will be your honorable mention. Congratulations.
Yeah, congratulations, Steve Harris, for your grand champion on the regular and number 93 in the Chicago Cutting Hands Training. And that is my sex sales Paulo Giana. And also, Lacey Patrick, your animal, that will be the regular grand champion. For the homebred champion for the junior division. Congratulations to you for your outstanding show.
Indoor Convention for Senior Champion of the Show. I would like you to go ahead and introduce me one more time. These animals that won in the 4-year-old class.
Was this your number one?
Well, he was Paul Rutter, Damien's Camel. He's going by that on the right and put it down arms.
22 in the back.
And the animal of second in class is entry number 122, Darrell W. Sierra from TML Cattle Company. And then in the 5-year-old cows, there's one by entry number 128, Franklin Golden Army from the West Coast All States. And then in the second place 5-year-old, there's entry number 124, Lake Bury Advent Ava. And then in the 6-year-old cows, the winner was entry number 133, Bologna Linda Janet Davis from Bill Slovis of ULIO. And entry number 134 was second. She is owned by the TML Cattle Company. And then in the 125,000 pound class, which was won by entry number 143, Legendary Honda. For the Legendary Arms of Chino, California. And second place was entry number 140. Happy's W. Bessie from Happy's Farms at all in Utah. There you have your winners and the 4-year-olds, the 5-year-olds, the 6-year-olds, and 125,000 pound winners for this year's Winter Show.
Well, in a selection here for our senior champion class, these are just four tremendous cows that we brought around here to the center of the ring, starting with that pair of four-year-old cows, real quality cows from NN, or a super pair of cows from me. They wear their udders well attached. They're cows that have style and balance when they get out on the move. Then our five-year-old cow here, another beautiful frame cow, a cow you can't really change anywhere in the frame when she gets out on the move. And then she wears her udder so well, so youthfully attached and such quality that whole way through the cow. And then our age cow here, another beautiful frame cow, a cow that excels in dairy strength. She's got width of muzzle and width down through the chest floor, and a cow that also wears a beautiful udder here and really stood the test of time quite nicely for me. And before we go too far, our age cow is going to be the best bred mare of our show here today, so certainly deserving of that. And now for our senior champion, reserve, and honorable mention. For me, it's pretty handy here. Our five-year-old cow is our senior champion cow. A cow I love, that beautiful frame too. A cow that has style, a cow that has balance. And yes, she's got dairy strength the whole way through, and I think it just makes a beautiful package here. A little closer for reserve, but the cow that follows that pattern with that dairy quality and that style when you get her out on the move is going to be our winning four-year-old cow. Pull her out there too. Just a beautiful, silky-hided cow, a cow that's high front-ended. You love the stretch to the head and neck. You love that quality that she has the whole way through. And just giving her advantage today, just a little freer in the movement on her hind legs and her age cow that's going to be your honorable mention. Congratulations.
Big congratulations to you for the Breeders' Grand Champion will be. Let me announce the Grand Champion, the champion of the senior champion, and of course will be number 128, the 5-year-old runaway Golden Army, and then the reserve senior champion will be number 112, followed by Stadium and Campbell, that runaway is well done. And then the Grand Champion, Breeders' Grand Champion for the show, will be entering the 132, what a blowout, Luna Chad Davis, from Bill Spokes of Real Life. Congratulations to all the winners. Thank you.
And the reserve junior champion from yesterday was Greenland Industry Laurel Zed. She was also for the West Coast Hastings. Now I'd like to introduce you also then our intermediate and reserve intermediate champions from the county. And our intermediate champion this morning was number 83, Happy Stolen Brave from the West Coast Hastings. And number 96 was reserve intermediate champion, Lovehill Golden Catrucia. She is from Team El Capitan. And then our senior grand champion, which is in the previous class, Breakaway Golden Army, entry number 128, West Coast Hastings. And our reserve senior champion was entry number 112, Paul Rogers, Damian Campbell, had a common lane and fledgling on arms. And before we ask that Jeff Burnett tell us who he selected for the overall grant that Richmond is this year, I think it's appropriate that we show our appreciation for the judges that he did today in lighting up. Thank you so much, Justin. Good luck to your group of show this year. We appreciate it. Fun watching you.
When our selection for grand champion here, first I'd like to say thanks for allowing me to be out here for the last 2 days to place the fine show that you've had. I really appreciate the effort put forth by all the exhibitors bringing these cattle from far and near and bringing them out in such good shape, and also your show management that runs a top-notch show here. And before we pick our champions, give all the exhibitors, your show management here a nice round of applause. They've really got a good thing going. If you missed our intermediate champion class here earlier, we had that beautiful black two-year-old out here that was your intermediate champion, a cow. I love her. Love her from end to end. I think a cow that's got a tremendous future. Our reserve cow didn't come back out here. I think she got milked out, but another cow that follows that pattern, just a cow with an outstanding future. And they're tremendous quality cows for me, and really an honor to be out here and have the opportunity to place them today. But for me today, I think we've got a tremendous pair of cows in our senior champions. They're going to stay our grand and reserve grand champion cows. I don't want to separate them. They're just quality from end to end. And we'll follow with that beautiful two-year-old will be your honorable mention. Congratulations.
And our grand champion, Greenway Gordon, congratulations. West Coast Hastings made a very impressive show today.
A couple of gals that took a lot of pictures in Africa, and I think they spent wanted to say hello to Jim before we had to leave here, and he kind of cornered me. But I appreciate the opportunity to be here very, very much. I think the lineup of cattle is just extraordinary. It's amazing how much 15, 16 years does as far as the quality of Holstein cattle. Everybody here does a tremendous job, and I'm just proud to be able to experience it. Thank you very much.
Have a safe trip back, Ron. Thank you so much. I would like to announce that for the premier breeder for this year's. Black and White for the Western Nationals Spring Holstein Show. The premier breeder will be Happy's Farms of Ogden, Utah. And to probably, yeah, let's give a big round of applause. That's great to achieve that. And bring everyone out. Pass out the premier breeder award. Please do while they're here in the ring. If you'd like to get come on up and receive that. And also at the same time, I would like to announce that when it comes to the premier exhibitor, probably no surprise to anybody, West Coast Holsteins. So congratulations to you. We got a big banner up here for you. West Coast Holsteins, you are the premier exhibitor for this year's 2012 Griffin Black and White Show at Western Spring National. Congratulations.
Yeah, those two together. Yep.
Ron Peterson and Larry Gerber. Ron, we got another. Ron Peterson, are you still here? Please get up to the announcer stand. We have something for you. I wish we'd have known when you were up here. We could have given it to you then. Ron Peterson, please come up to the announcer stand.
Justin, and he's got the placings for the best three females. Well, we had five real nice groups out here for best three in our group. We're one with that real fancy two-year-old in there, and a nice junior three production cow. They were all right at the top of their classes, and real uniform quality grants still. And then our group follows in second. Just a little dance to that maturity, a little more capacity to the runners all the way through, a little deeper, rather rich structure than a real nice other group that we had followed out in third. Group in third, just a little more uniformity the whole way through, a little snugger about their mammary systems and the groups that follow in fourth and fifth.
Thank you so much, Justin. On this best three females, we've got quite a bit going on right now. I do want to mention that I'll mention the winners, and then I'll. First of all, this class is sponsored by Wendell's Dairy Service and Biovet and Redmond Minerals. And a man that was really very responsible knew the emphasis of how important it is to win this public class, the senior best three females. Mr. Charles Mickelson, his son Wendell, is here with me right now. I'm going to ask Wendell to say a few words, and I always enjoy listening to what Wendell says about his dad and his contributions to this show.
Thanks, Jim. It is a great honor to be associated in the Richmond Black and White Western Spring National Show. I am committed to the legacy that my father had here. He really believed in breeding good dairy cattle. And he felt the epitome of the show was the best three females. And so it's a great privilege to still represent him in this class. And I really appreciate all the hard work that all the breeders do to develop and breed such good herded cows and the effort they put in to bring these cattle to the show. I was taught at an early age a love for the cattle, a love for the show. And there's a lot of dad's good friends still here. And I appreciate this opportunity. Thanks, Jim.
Thank you, Wendell. And if you'd like to report the placings for the best three females, first place went to Pappy's Farms. Second place went to the entry from Harris Dairy Lanes. And third went to Utah State University. And fourth was the entry from Estelle Dairy. And then fifth to the entry from Meredith Ball. Now showing you the breeders are the five females class number 27.
Yeah, I don't know.
that?
Well, five real nice groups here in our exhibitors third class. And again, a real nice group to start with here. Really uniform there. Examples were good. Other than one of the strength there in our heifers, just a little more power in their heifers than the next group, second. Second group over the third, just a little advantage, just a little more consistency and uniformity in their cows. And our real youthful group that we have here in third, real youthful on our cows. We like the way they carry their motor out. And just like to give them a little more uniformity the whole way through the new bump. And two more real nice cows.
And the next class is the Proving Sedan, and then the Dam and Daughter class. And if you'd like to mark your catalog to class number 7, first place will get entry number 152 from Happy's Farms. Second place, entry number 150, there is Dairyland. Third, to entry number 153 from Utah State. Fourth, the entry from S-Tail. And fifth, the entry number 151 from American Ball.
It's a USB that has this, the SD card, and that's it. I think this is positive. I can't use it.
Group third is a little more mature than they do the next one, so they all have, but again, seven little high schoolers down there.
And then the trophy stands in first place will be entry number 158. That is a trophy of Markwell Durham Raven, and that is owned. This is a combination ownership from Tappa, Georgia, and West Coast Hall States. Entry number 167 for Yardview will be second in the class. Entry number 156 will be third. And I'll give you the rest of the places. Judge Burdett, your comments on the produce stand. You're now showing the daughter class. But anyway, for the produce, it should be 154 was fifth, 155 was fourth, 156 was third, 157 was seventh, 158 was first, 159 was sixth, and if you're using 167 was second.
Well, to finish up our show here today, four-year-old ice groups are today on the daughter. And starting with that group of that nice red four-year-old, that senior camp, just real uniform for me, real quality from end to end, and just a real stylish group here, certainly to be proud of. And then kind of taking anything away from that group in second, that real nice age count, senior, I think it was right up in the top of the class. Just a real tremendous pair here, and a little advantage in their overall there, and just all the way through to the next great group here in third. Group in third, just a little more maturity the whole way through the yearly effort. Than our younger group in fourth.
That concludes the show unless there's a get a sire coming in. And if you would like to report that they have a daughter class, entry number 160 was first in the class, entry 161 was fourth, entry 162 was second, and we had an added entry from Butterdale Holdings was third in the damn daughter class. That concludes the show. We've got another one of the books. Everybody have a safe trip home with your cattle. We'll see you next time.